time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, he broke the bread. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and the eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Let us proclaim this mystery of our faith.
May the blessing of God.
God's peace be with each one of you.
And with your spirit.
At a distance, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
We repeat the words of Mary, the Lord has done great things for us, especially as now we are invited to receive the Lord Jesus in this Eucharist. In preparation, we pray, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. His body and his blood bring us to his eternal.
Please wait for the ushers to direct you to the line. It is very important that you consume the body of Christ immediately. There will be two separate lines in the back for anyone who would like to receive the Holy Communion on the tongue. There will be one line by the St. Catherine's icon for those who are sitting on the right side, and another line by Our Lady of Guadalupe if you are sitting on the left. Thank you.
Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Friendly reminder, please visit our website for our weekly updates. For your convenience, you are encouraged to go on our website and sign up for online giving. When receiving Holy Communion, it is very important that you consume the body of Christ immediately. We would like to welcome Paul Kelly, who will be our newest member of our Finance Council. He comes to us with many years of experience and is looking forward to working with the rest of the members. Paul is also very involved in our liturgical ministries and St. Vincent de Paul. Please make him feel welcome. This is our liturgy moment. How long should I serve in the Eucharistic ministry? The diocese gives us these guidelines. It is the responsibility of the pastoral leadership in the parish, usually the pastor, to encourage ministers every 3 years to discern the continuing call to this ministry. Together, they can prayerfully determine whether or not a recommitment to another term of service is appropriate. That means to serve in this ministry is a mutual agreement of both the pastor and the minister. The pastor, after praying with the minister, may ask the minister to serve in another ministry. Thank you. We have birthday blessings today. We invite everyone who is celebrating a birthday in the month of August to please stand up for a special birthday blessing.
It's a rest of the rest of your day. Okay. I'd like to bless friends to each year as we celebrate another birthday, the gift of life that we have received from God. We want to offer a prayer of thanksgiving. Let us pray. Loving God, you created all the peoples of the world, and you know each of us by name. Bless them with your love and friendship, that they may grow in wisdom, knowledge, and grace. May they love their families always and be faithful to their friends. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It's my little birthday present. You know, the catechism teacher was teaching the young children about Feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And so at the end, she said to them, how many of you would like to go to heaven and be with the Heavenly Mother? All of the kids except one raised a hand. And she said, Mary, don't you want to go to heaven and see our Heavenly Mother? And Mary said, I can't, because my mommy said to come home right after class. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.